Hello friends, peace be upon you. Today we will learn about this glossy effect. To give such a glossy effect, I have used the curves adjustment. Let's see how we can create such an effect with curves adjustment, so let's get started. This is an Adobe Photoshop logo. We will create this effect on it. So first we will pick the magic wand tool. By pressing shift we have to make three selections. Here we don't want this blue color. So go to image, adjustment, hue/saturation. Check colorize box. This will colorize our selection in this way. The value of hue should be 0. The saturation value should be 0. And lightness value should be 60 or 50, it means to be a little gray. Then click OK. We have changed this blue color to gray color. Now press Ctrl+J and the copy via layer will be created. So, we have created this copy via layer here. Now we will open its blending options. And first select bevel and emboss. And we'll keep its style inner bevel. Technique is smooth. We'll keep depth at 400%. And its size will be 40 pixels. The shading angle will be 120 degrees. Altitude will be kept at 30 degrees. Check out use global light. Have to check anti-aliased. And the gloss contour we will keep linear. Highlight mode screen with white color with 75% opacity. Shadow mode is multiply with black color and opacity is 75%. Then press OK. Now let's convert this layer to a smart object. Now we will open the blending options again. This time we will slightly change the setting of the bevel and emboss. Instead of inner we will select outer bevel and style. Depth will keep 100%. The size will be 5 pixels and soften 0 pixels. Angle is 120 and altitude is 30 in shading. We will change gloss contour. Select ring double instead of linear. Other setting is same as before. Check inner glow. Blend mode is screen. Opacity will be kept at 75%. And here we will select the gradient. Its color on the left side should be white. While on the right side the opacity is to be kept at 0. That is, there should be no color on the right side. Then click OK. Now to select inner shadow. 50 or 60% amount is to be kept in brightness. Opacity is to be kept at 80%. The size should be kept at 20 pixels. Then click OK. So this effect will look something like this. Now create a layer of curves adjustment. We will create gloss effect with it. We'll do the shadows a bit more here. We'll move the midtones down. And we will move the highlights upwards. That is increase highlights. Midtones little bit lower. We will create a duplicate layer of this. Change the blend mode to pin light for this layer. And on this layer if we need some more adjustments. And while making this adjustment, we will keep an eye on the text or logo. And here is gloss effect. Adjust shadows for more perfection. So this gloss effect we created with the help of curves adjustments. Now select all three layers and group them. Now create a new document. Width 1920 pixels. Height 1080 pixels and resolution 72 pixels/inch. Color mode RGB, but background content is black. And create it. Now we have to move this group to the new document. The way to move the group is to press and hold up Control. This will select the entire group. So, press Control to move this group to the new document. We will unlock our black layer. By pressing Ctrl plus T, we will transform the group. By pressing Alt, we will increase its size. We will align this group on the document. If you press Ctrl and click on the layer, the selection will be done. Select the group and align it horizontally and vertically. This will move the group to the center of the document. Press Ctrl plus D to deselect. Select the black layer and import a texture here. And that's the texture of this one. I am dragging and dropping this texture on document. Press Ctrl plus Shift and stretch it on whole document. Then press Enter. And the texture layer I am rasterizing. By selecting the group, we will open its blending options. And we will only give drop shadow here. Blend mode is normal and color is black. Its angle will be 120 degrees. The distance will be kept at 20 pixels. Keep the spread at 10%. Keep the size at 20 pixels and click OK. Now on top of this group, we will create a black solid color layer. Now the layer thumbnail is selected and the mask is not selected. Then go to Filter, Render, Lens Flare. It will ask, Covered to Smart Object, so, convert it. Here is Lens Flare, adjusted for document. Press OK and it will appear on document. Change Blend Mode to Screen. Select Lens Flare Effect. We can't get this lens flare to move. If you select the layer thumbnail and move it up, it will move. Bring lens flare on letter P. We are seeing its edges. Now we will select the lens flare mask. And with the help of a soft round brush, we'll delete from the outside. This is one way. It is giving a bright light effect. I am disabling this layer for the second method. Create a blank layer and set foreground white color. Take a soft round brush for next method. And give a stroke on letter P. And change blend mode to screen. And there is light effect on letter P. Lens flare effect is on whole document. But second method is effect on limited area. It is your choice what you want to use. Now, select an active texture layer. Open curves adjustment layer for texture and clip it. So it affect only on texture layer. Make it darken with help of curves adjustment. Zoom in and see. Gloss effect is ready. Now I want to give an effect on top of this logo or text. Make duplicate layer for texture by pressing Ctrl plus J. Going to delete lens flare layer. Move this duplicate layer of texture above the group. Open group and select logo layer. Press Ctrl and click on it. It will make a selection. Select texture layer and press Ctrl plus J to create a copy via layer. After that, delete texture layer. Change blend mode to pin light for layer we created copy via layer. Texture effect is on logo. Enable and disable and see difference. Texture effect is on logo as well. This is way we can give glossy effect to logo or text by using curves. I hope you like it. Hit like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.